miss. I got most of the horses secure and the chicken.
Well, thank you, Amos, but it's the herd I'm worried about.
I know. They're scattered all over the valley and beyond. The weather is coming in real fast.
So what do you suggest, Amos? We leave the herd out there to be scattered by the storm and ourselves left here to die without a livelihood?
Can I help?
No, miss. If the men get caught out in that storm, they're gonna die.
And if we lose our herd, we'll all die, you stupid man.
Doesn't sound like we're left with much of a choice then. Come on, Amos. Round up your men. Let's get the herd.
Dang.
Before the weather gets any worse. That sky don't look good. I'm starting to think somebody up there is conspiring against me. Are you a religious man?
Not in any real sense. Sometimes I tell myself things happen for a reason. Like what brought me here was fate come a-calling. But nobody made my path for me.
We all need to look for answers somewhere. Some in big old books. Others in big old bottles of whiskey.
Believing in some kind of divine purpose ain't gonna give me my wife and kid back. Pastor's who we are, Miss McFarland. And there ain't no changing that. Faith is a luxury I can't afford.
We have two herds out grazing in different pastures. We'll need to merge them and bring them all back.
I think we can handle that.
The cows get real ornery in bad weather. It's more work, but I'll show you how to deal with them. It's gonna be difficult to talk in this weather. Stay close. We don't want to lose each other.
Come on! Slow down!
Whoa there!
Whoa there!
Drive them over to the pasture by the old oak tree. We'll merge them with the other herd there.
Whoa.
Hurry! We gotta move that herd!
Slow it up now! Let's go. Whoa. Hey. Whoa, whoa.
preacher one day.
Thank you, Mr. Farland. Whoa, whoa!
Excuse me, Mr. Marston. Have you seen my father anywhere?
No.
He went out this morning to ride the land and was supposed to be back hours ago. I don't know. The ranch hands have been out looking, but so far they've found nothing.
Well, come on. Let's go look for him.
Come on. Let's see if we can go.
Go!
Feeling about this. It's not like him to be away for so long.
Don't worry. We'll find him.
He's not as young as he used to be. What if he's hurt himself?
Your father can still handle himself just fine, Miss McFarland. He's built like an oak.
You're probably right, but I can't help worrying. He's all I've got.
Don't you have any brothers or sisters, Miss McFarland?
I had six brothers, but five of them died, either from sickness or foolish choices.
And the other one?
He left for the East and never came back. Must be getting on for 10 years ago now. He's a high and mighty banker in New York, according to his last letter.
He should be here, helping you and your pa.
I don't want his help. He can live his life any way he wants. But when I see those city fellers coming in on the railway, all dressed up like a sore toe, I fear a little for his soul. He switched his saddle for a tie, and that's fine. I just never met a man in a tie I could trust. Who's that over there? Daddy! What happened?
Nothing nice. Wrestlers, I guess. Maybe the Baller twins, that bunch. Now you head back to the ranch right now and fetch your wagon.
Yes, sir.
Marston, you watch after her.
I'll do that, sir. Come on!
Really? What could have happened to those poor men? And their horses were dead, too.
I think we should get back there as soon as we can.
Come on, let's hurry.
Blow it up,
man. Go there. Stay with me. I've got a bad feeling about this. Who could have done something like that?
Your boss seemed to have an idea who it was. Let's just do what he says and get the wagon.
Rustlers, I've got a good mind to head over to Pike's Basin myself.
I don't think that's a good idea.
And you're no better. How many men have you killed?
Do you really want to know?
It's disgusting.
You never met the men I killed.
I heard the way you talk about that gang you were in, like there was some twisted morality to what you did.
We all have a code.
Oh my God, the barn's on fire.
Come on.
We can't get through the doors. It's too dangerous.
Somebody get them horses out.
Put it on.
Mr. Marston, please. See if you can get in through the lock.
There.
There ain't enough of us.
Los caballos.
Help me, will you?
Come on!
did it! Now get the horses out!
Sure know how to handle yourself. Thanks, Marston.
Yes, John, thanks. You saved the ranch.
If you'll excuse me, I've got chores to attend to. Hey, hold on a second over there.
Sincerely, John. Thank you.
Well, I did all I could, Miss McFarland. Sorry about all the damage. That gang seems to really want you out of here.
Yeah, well, my father fought Indians. I scarcely think we're gonna be frightened by some white trash.
White trash can be pretty frightening.
Well, they don't frighten me.
Good.
John, my family owes you a great debt.
I think you got enough debt. You saved my life. All I ask of you is this. If I get back home and get my farm started back up, you'll sell me some cattle. I prefer doing business with people I know.
Of course, Mr. Marston. It'd be my pleasure. Well, you get some rest. I've got to go see how my father's bearing up.
And I can tell you, with no uncertainty, that miracle cures are no laughing matter. I bid you good day, sir. Oh, Mr. Marston, good to see you. How have you been keeping?
I'm well, Mr.
Mr. West Dickens. Nigel West Dickens of East Sheep, London, New Waverly, New York, and Armadillo, New Austin. At your service.
At my service.
At everyone's service, at the service of science, of knowledge, of life.
How are your wounds?
Much, much better. But then they would be.
Would be?
I know a cure for all ailments, Mr. Marston.
Ah, I'm sure you do. And I'm sure for just $2 an ounce, I could live forever.
Oh, but for you, sir, I'd do a bulk discount rate of $1.95 an ounce, as long as you buy 100 ounces or more. That's a lot of immortality.
Oh, give it up, old man.
That's Mr. West Dickens to you, boy.
Give it up, old man.
Listen, Marston, I'm broke, but this stuff is good. It works. I need a healthy young man like you. Come along, and let's ride over to my newest customer at Ridgewood, and I'll explain while we go.
Okay.
Head for Ridgewood Farm, John, and hurry. There are people there in dire need of my tonic.
I heard about you, Mr. West Dickens.
And I about you, John Marston.
Hoodwinking the weak, gullible out of their hard-earned money.
For the love of God, try to stay on the road. Get back on the road. We'll have nothing left by the time we get to Ridgewood. My dear boy, it's you who is gullible, if I may be so bold. Stay on the road. You're going to destroy the merchandise. For he is such ill-informed scuttlebutt.
You're as full of wind as a horse with the collar.
I have been blessed with the gift of language, and for that I will not apologize. But the West Dickens elixirs speak for themselves. If my tonic is such a sham, how do you explain the fine fettle in which you find me? Last time you saw me, I was knocking at death's door.
You should thank the doctor for that. But I reckon you were acting it up worse than it was.
Act I can, John. A more convincing Othello there has never been. And so shall you, a fair Iago or Cassio.
I don't like the sound of this.
Showmanship, John. The flourish. A bow. We are operating in a competitive marketplace. Our product must stand out.
And how does this involve me?
We're going to use your God-given talents to our advantage. For the love of God, try to stay on the road!
I'm really starting to regret
this. I'll drop you off at the outskirts of Ridgewood. That way, it won't look like we came together. Once I'm set up, saunter nonchalantly into the crowd that is sure to be forming. Eventually, I will call you up to try my tonic. After extolling the virtues, I will have you perform a few feats of wonder to amaze and impress the paying public. Best you alight here, dear boy, so no one sees us arriving together. See you shortly, and remember, showmanship!
Souls of Chola Springs, gather round, gather round. Do you suffer from rheumatism, lumbago, acute chronic sciatic, neurologic or inflammatory pain? Well, I represent the only company that makes the genuine article that cures headaches, neuralgia, earache, toothaches, backache, swelling, sprains, sore chests, swelling of the throats, contracted cords and muscles, anxieties and ravaged nerves, stiff joints, wrenches, dislocations, cuts and bruises, and it adds vitality and vigor to the healthy man.
But can you prove it, old man?
Oh, I'm sure there's some customer here who could prove the qualities of its by... Take a drink right now. You, sir, come up here. Step right up. That's the spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, pay close attention. This poor, wretched volunteer, entirely unknown to me, will demonstrate the effects of Dr. West Dickens' own patent tonic. Be you a cowpoke or athlete, this miraculous elixir developed with the wisdom of the East keeps the muscles supple and relaxes the cords. It loosens the joints and gives a feeling of youth and vigor to the whole system. Not possible, I hear you say. Well, doubt no longer. Faith can move mountains, but I ask not for faith. I am a man of science, and today science will be vindicated. Your eyesight is greatly improved, is that not so, friend?
If you say so.
That's right, it is. You heard him. What a good sport you are, sir. Now, gaze over yonder at that porch. If you squint, you may just be able to make out the skull that's hanging there. Go ahead, friend. Shoot that skull and demonstrate the miraculous eyesight you now possess. The eyesight of an eagle, granted by imbibing Dr. West Dickens' own patent tonic.
Anybody can make that shot. This man is a fraud. If your eye is so damn sharp, why don't you try shooting my hat out of the air?
My friends, our test case has been challenged to shoot a gentleman's hat out of the sky above our heads.
You can fool these people. you ain't fooling me. Right. Let's just see how sharp you is with a moving target.
Here it comes. Behold the power of elixir, plucked out of the sky!
Hey! Hey! What? You think you can put a hole in a man's hat and just walk away, do you? Hey, it don't work like that around here, mister. Come on! Are you a man or not?
A challenge of battle has been offered to our volunteer. Prepare for a display of Herculean brawn.
Say goodnight! Come on then, partner!
I'm taking this nice and slow.
He is merely playing with you, ladies and gentlemen.
After
you want a broken nose, friend?
Like a girl.
Hit me, pal. Hit me. I've had about enough of you.
Is it like licking
you
fire
messed with the wrong
knife.
Fella? We playing Marquis of Queensberry rules? Normally, I don't fight animals. Ain't this fun?
There it is, skeptics and dissenters. Irrefutable proof. Do not let this opportunity pass you by.
Look, he's over there. Go get
this
him.
This ends now.
Watch out! He's got a gun!
Who the hell do you think you are? You ain't leaving here alive.
Of deadly accuracy that can only be afforded by the West Dickens elixir. Come, I have plenty for all.
You'll be fine. Get out of my way.
Hey, where are you going?
I want a bottle. Get me a bottle, please. One of them right here.
No harm in trying one bottle, I suppose.
Well, I think that went kind of well, don't you?
I'm just glad that my normal job involves either chasing after cattle or murderers. Not the likes of you, mister.
Don't be like that.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I'd like to say my goodbyes, head on back to the real world.
Wait, sir. I've been thinking about your predicament, and I think I may have an idea. I've been thinking I could be your cunning Odysseus. Beware of the Greeks burying gifts, sir. Mm-hmm. Williamson had better beware. We will make them into Trojans.
I don't rightly get you.
I want you to go and see my old friend, Seth. He can come across as a little curious, but I'm sure you two will get on. He's most often found at Coote's Chapel. He's very devout.
Why see him?
Because between him and me, we can get those gates to open for you, and you can walk right in, just like in Homer's great Trojan yarn!